our next poem, our next unit number 3.1, the plate of gold. This is the story told in form of this poem. This is a story type poem. A clear message to convey is a God love those who truly lovely their fellows beings. That means here given the your story told in this poem. One day there falls in the great Banaras temple court a wondrous plate of gold, whereon this word were reads to him who loves best a gift for heavens. Thereat the priest made proclamations at the midday hours each day. Let those assembles who for virtue deem their right to heavens gift the best, and we will hear the dead of Meriden, and so adjusted. That means here given meaning of this word. In first line, the loveth best me here, one who loves God most, and here proclamation means no public statement. Here given the public statements. Then here given adjusted, then that means consider as declared. D means consider, regard. First stanza, one day there falls in great Banaras temple court the wondrous plate of gold, wherein this word where reads to him who loveth best a gift from heaven thereat. That means one day the wonderful plate of gold falls in a great temple court is a Banaras, and on where written the word to whom who love the best a gift from heaven. Next stanza, the priest made proclamation at the midday hours each day. Let those assembles who for virtue deem their right to heaven's gifts the best, and we will hear the deaths of Mary Duns and adjust. That means in the second stanza, that means seeing this, the priest made a public statement that all those who thought that they were virtuous enough to climb heaven gift should assemble to meet day each day. The priest would hears all the dead of Mary Dunn, consider them, and they declare winner. The news ran swift as light, and soon from every quarters came nobles and munshis, hermits, scholars, holy men, and all renowned for gracious or for the splendid deeds. Meanwhile, the priest and Solomon's counseling sat heard, each had done the merit best, the gift of heaven, so for ear climates come and went. Here quarters means, what is the meaning of quarters here? Corner. Then renowned means to renowned, means to well know. Solomon's means to serious, and claimants means those who state their right to get something. So in first line, ran swift light, and soon from every quarters came nobles and munshis, hermits, scholar, holy men, and all renowned for the gracious and for splendid deeds. Meanwhile, the priest in Solomon's council sat and heard what each had done the merits best, the gift of heaven, so far ears claimants came and went. That means the news moved swiftly as light. That means from every side came nobles, munshis, hermits, scholar, holy men, and all those who were famous for their gracious or splendid deeds. The prestige sat together in all seriousness and heard what each one had done and who was one most suitable to receive the gift from heavens. And at last, after the patience winging of the worth of the all, the priest bestowed the plate of gold on one who seemed the largest lover of the race, whose whole estate within the year had been parted among the poor. The man, all trembling with his joy, advanced to make golden plate. Olu, at his figure's first touch, he changed the bestest leaves, all stood aghast. But when the helpless claimants drop it changing on the floor, heaven's gardens was again transferred to shining gold. That means here the after the patience wingings of the wrath, here given the bestow means presented a gift, parted means to distributed, and then aghast means shocked and horrible, hapless means unfortunate. Then guerdons means reward. That means in this stanza poet stated that for years all these who could dare the climb to plate came and went. Finally, after the patiently judging the worth of all the climates, the priest presented the plate to person who seemed to love humans being the most, and the person had distributed all his wealth among the poor during this year. The man, trembling with joy, come forward to take the place. However, at the first touch of his finger, the plate turned into chip of lead. Everyone was horrified, but when the unfortunate claimants dropped its changing to the floor, the gift from heaven once again turned into the shining of gold. And well for them was the gold of charity, for every pilgrim to the temple gate praised God that love might thus approve itself before the tester, and so coin rained freely in the outstretched hand. But none of who gave so much turn to look into the poor sad eyes of this begged. That means in this stanza for another year, the priest got together and judged the people who has came to claim gift. Their time it was awarded to someone. That means the time of the awarded to someone, and three times the plate turned into lead, indicating that heaven had not accepted the claim of the person. Meanwhile, the plenty of poor and crippled beggars from the street lay about near the temple gate. They hoped to inspire love in each claimant who hoped to win the gift. For this would mean money from them. Every pilgrim who visited the temple praised God and generously gave alms to beggars in wish to prove that they were the one who loved the best. However, none of the people who was turned around the look into the poor and sad eyes of beggar. Then here the second year had almost passed, but still the plate of gold by whomever touched was turned to lead. The length there came simple peasants now aware that the strange contest for the gift of God to pay vow within the temple as passed along the line of shriveled beggars. All his soul was moved within him to sweet pity, and the tear welled up the Timberlands in ear. That means here shriveled means dry up and wrinkled. Then second year had almost passed on, but still the plate of gold turned into the lead whenever anyone touched it. Then one day, after the long time, simple peasant came at the temple to pay. Wow, he was not aware of this strange competition for the gift of God. As he passed along the line, shriveled and wrinkled beggars, his soul was moved with the pity for them, and tears came to his eyes. Then, now by the temple gate, there lay a poor shore creature, blind and shunned by all. But when the pleasant came and saw the sightless face and trembles maimed hands, he could not pass, but knelt and took both palm in his and slopped. He said, "O thou, my brother, bear the troubles bravely. God is God." Then he arises to walk straightway across the court and entered where they ragged of the dead of love before the priest. That means now by the gate. Now near the temple gate there was a poor, sore, blind beggar who was rejected by everyone. When the peasant saw his blind face and trembling, crippling hand, he could not pass by, but knelt and took both his hands in his. The peasant softly called the beggars. His brother told him, "Bear his trouble bravely, for God was good." Then he rose and went straight across the court and entered the place where the people were arguing angrily with the priest about their dead of love. Then pleasant listened sadly, and while he is listening sadly then had turned away, but something moved the priest who held the plate of gold is beckons to pigeons. So he came, not understanding on obeys, and stretched his hand and took his cast vessel. Lo, it shone with the tricks of his farmer's lusters, and amazed then all. "Son," cried the priest, "rejoice, the gift is God." In thin and one by one departed, but the pigeons knelt and prayed of bowing his head above the golden plate while over his soul like a morning streamed the love of the God. That means the pigeons listened sadly for some time, then turned away. Something made the priest who held the plate of gold to call him. The pleasant came not understanding the reason. He stretched his hand and took the sacred vessels. What is surprise, it soon with three times with farmer seen. The amazement of all these people there, the priest told the pigeons to rejoice, for the gift from the God was his, for he was the one of who loved best. Everyone agreed, and one by one the left, but the pigeons knelt down, prayer to God, bowing his head above the golden plate and over his soul, as if it was early morning, streamed up the love of God. That means in this poem, poets tell us the story with the strong message behind it. The message is that God love those who love their fellow being. Understand? That means in this poem, poet told the story of simple story in this poem.